Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Yeah, this entrance here. Well, actually, before I get to that, the week's question. I said to you, do you want me to get, what are they? It's the Auto Combine mod and Follow Me. Do you want me to start using them on this map? Because I said to you originally that I wasn't going to use them. I was going to just use vanilla methods on this map and then possibly use them on the next map. But I've decided to open it up to the floor. Let me know what you think. Head down below, yes or no. It's your vote. It's your game. I have added the traffic back to the game. You've probably seen the car go past. Just so we can see how it will respond. I will keep an eye on the frame rate and we will just check it out. It seems okay so far. Now, I said that I was going to bring up a load of straw up here so that we could put them in for the beef and the pigs. And the beef and the pigs currently, well, it's on 0%, so when I just started up the game, we have 29 and 30 animals ready to take to market. So we will be doing that soon. We're doing lots of odd jobs today and tomorrow, same as we were yesterday. And then next week, we're going to do the sugar beet harvest. You probably realize that I won't be able to get that big Marshall trailer in here. It's just not going to fit round the corners, is it? So I did manage to get it in here, and I took a sort of a secret route. I found a way to get this trailer in here. It's really difficult to maneuver it around this yard. It is definitely not easy, but there is a way to get in and out of here without actually having to go around all those corners. And it's not a way that you would normally use, but it does work. So we will take this trailer back to the main yard now, and then we will come back up here and we will do the straw spreading. And we go through here. There's no hedge through here. It's just some long grasses and plants. So there is just enough room to squeeze through. You've got a tree just there. And then all you got is a couple of little shrubs and a few bits of grass and a few plants. So there is a way to get in and out of this shed, which is absolutely fantastic. So that is how I got the straw in there, and if we need to get this big long Marshall trailer in there again, that's the way we'll go. But the other trailers, we've been able to get in and out through the normal entrance, which is the one that we would use. We wouldn't want to be cutting through there too often because it'd get a bit muddy outside. So I'm going to take this trailer back to the main yard, and then as soon as I've done that, we can start putting straw in for the beef and the pigs. Right, I've come back up here, and I've never actually used this machine before. I've always put them into the feed mixers. So we will, I think you just gotta put a bale on the back. You open the door on the back like that. And then you put a bale on the back. And as soon as that's done, you can close it up and then start spreading the bale. Now I brought up a load of bales. I actually brought most of the bales that we've got and just laid them out here. So I figured that we would use them on and off. So let me come around here. We will just grab one bale. And I have been thinking also about whether or not I should use the PTO, or the manual attachment mod, where you've got to get out and join the PTO and the hitch and that to the machine. And I've had a lot of I need to line that up a bit better. It doesn't like to go in on two spikes. It only likes to go in on one single spike. There we go. But yes, I've had a lot of requests to use it. And I've been thinking about it. It would be a lot more realistic. So I'm thinking that I'm not actually going to put that one up for a question. I am just going to get it. And I did actually intend to have it ready for this episode, but I don't have it for this episode. So I do apologize for that. I really want to actually put that back on the other spike that it was on. Perhaps if I move, I'm going to move that tractor forward a little bit. It's in the wrong place. We haven't got that lined up properly. So let's just lift that one up again, which would be that one. And if I move forwards there and then close it down again, or open it out again, rather. I'll climb back in here. I'm going to take that one off there, and I'm going to go back onto this side, and we'll just put the boom out a little bit, and then we'll be able to see what we're doing. So pick that one up there, and if I extend the boom, it's rather a long way out, but that'll be all right. Now I've got to get this bale just to go in the back of the machine right there. There we go. Yeah, that's not supposed to happen, I don't think. I'll tell you what, can we put it in the other way round? Do we have to put it sideways? Can't we just put it in this way? Let's see. I reckon that we could put it in this way round. Although I don't think these machines are supposed to work like that. Let's try chucking that in there. There you go. Stay. We'll see what it does. I think the way that these machines actually work is that they unroll it. So technically it's not supposed to go in that way. It is supposed to go the way that we had it first, but it didn't like that. So let's try that. Close it up. Well, it squeezes the bale in there. That is in nice and tight. So what else have we got to do? Open door. I guess you just drive in and it will now operate as it should. Let's try. We drive in here. I'm going to do this one out of cab. Oh, yeah. You just unload. Okay, that sounds pretty good. We'll do that. Starts up. Starts spreading. That's brilliant. We are going to need to come up here and muck out as well. That's another job that we're going to do. We will hire a muck spreader. Right, that's one bale in there. How many bales can we put in? Straw. They got 4,000 straw. I'm guessing we won't be able to put two full bales in. But let's just drive. We'll just do it in a circle. We'll go round in a circuit. I come back through and we'll just do the same again. Squeeze up through here. And if I park there, open the gate. And now we'll go into this one. And see if we can get another one in there. Should be easy enough. We can boom in a little bit. There we go. I shouldn't be putting two bale spikes in through it. Now, I'm going to see if I can do it this way. I don't think I can. I don't think it is going to let me do it like this without rolling the bale everywhere. Oh, we might do it. We might. Come on. Well, this is very exciting. Very exciting times. Can we do this? Go on. Yes! Ha ha, brilliant. Now that is the way it's supposed to go in there. Excellent. Right, that is a bale in there properly. So we'll go back in here and we'll unload again. It's probably not going to allow us to tip everything. We'll go down the other end because we spread straw in these two. Yeah. Oh, no. I don't want to open it. I want to unload. Like that. Drive down through here. There, it's not going to let me put any more in. That is maximum. So I'll come out of here and we go into the pig pen. Let's do the pigs now. We'll do this next one from in cab. And we've still got grass to do. I've got a lot of grass to do. I've got the mowers already. We bought the mowers. So we still need to do that. So we've got to feed the cows and sheep. We've got loads of pigs and cattle that we want to take to market. And... well, we got to muck these out. We've got quite a few different jobs that we need to do before we can get going with our sugar beet. We'll probably use that small trailer there for doing the mucking out. Might actually be better if we buy a few more each animal. I don't know if I got anything left in that trailer. I'll have a look in a minute. But I want to get one more bale of straw in here so that I can feed the pigs, bed down the pigs. Open that one and climb out. There we go. Right, I'm going to just do this one. We've seen a few of them now. So I will do this one quickly on my own. And then we can... Actually, the next job that we're going to do is we're going to do the silage. We need to do some grass. We need to mow some grass. So I'm going to mow two fields of grass. And... That was really, really bad driving. I just rammed the post then. So, yeah, I'm going to do two fields of grass, and when I've done the two fields of grass, we'll gather a load up because we've got our forager there, a forage wagon, rather. Don't think I'm going to hire a bigger one for today. I think we'll just stick with the one that we've got because I can go a few times if I need to. Right, is that going to close in there okay? A little bit of a squeeze, but he does get in there eventually. Going to try and hop out now, isn't he? Ooh, careful. Yeah, that bale is jumping around a bit, it'll probably be all right. So anyway, I'm going to go and feed. Actually, you know what? I think we can watch the pigs being fed, having the straw put in, because we've never done this job before, so it's not going to hurt. And I might even leave the grass until next episode, because I could always... Right, let's start spreading. There we go. I don't know how much of this one it's going to take. It probably won't take all of it. Yeah, it's left a little bit behind. Let's just put it right there. I don't think we need to worry about... actually, because we need to muck this out... Right, I know what I'm going to do. We are going to do the grass now, and then next time I've got to have a muck spreader ready so that we can muck out, and then we can take the manure from here direct to a field somewhere. So I'm going to park this lot up and go and get the mowers hitched on, ready to go. Before I do that, though, there are a couple of insignificant little jobs I need to do. I said that I would be selling the Don 680, and I never actually got round to it. I brought it up here and parked it, and that was it. I've also brought the New Holland, because we're not going to need that one anymore. So we'll sell this one first, 34,000. And now the Don 680. Now what we're going to have to do with this one is, if I start it up, we're going to have to unhitch this trailer somewhere that we can use it again. Hardly got any fuel left in this thing. I'll put the trailer right here. Like this. That can stay there. I'm hoping that it's not going to be in the way too much just there. That should be okay. So I'll unhitch that one. Like that. Come over here and off-hitch the header in the cell chamber. There we go. And... Right, lower that one down, and then unhitch, back out, and M to open the door, there we go. Right, I'll do the last of it from in the cab, just because we can. Right, sell that one for 4,000, and climb back into the machine. We want to close the door, bring the steering forward, and I'll go round and hitch in this whole crop header. Easy does it. There we go. Right, that trailer we're going to keep because we bought that one. So we are going to keep it. Lower this one down. There we go. And actually, I think we'll be all right just parking here. So lift the steering wheel up out of the way. Turn that one off. And we are done. That is the end of our use with the Don 680. It's been a wonderful little machine, but we are going to move on to something a little bit bigger next time. So that one will get us nearly 14,000, and that one will get us just over 7,000. So we've got £141,000 now, which is not too shabby, really. But anyway... Now that I've done that, I will get back to the farm, and we can start with the mowing. I'm going to wash the tractor off first, because a clean tractor would be best. So we'll just rinse this one off. And then we will get the mower that we got over there, so Fendt mower, I think it is. I can't remember now. We'll have a look. The New Holland is up there, and it's registering that it's got straw in it, so I might actually... nip back up there at some point and empty that out, just so that it doesn't show on our list the whole time, because that gets slightly frustrating, at least to me. So if I unhitch it, it shouldn't register anywhere. Now, that mower, if we come in here and off-hitch the front weight, just here, so I'll put that one there, lower it down, there we go. Unhitch that one, and then I'll move over and get that mower. Then we can go out in the field and we can get those other two mowers to go on the back. And the great thing about these two mowers, or the three mowers, is that they have a swathing option. This one has a swathing option anyway, which we already know about. And there is another mower that could go with the two that I've got in the field. But I figured, as we've already bought this front-mounted one, we'd just as well go with this one. So let me just come out here. There we go. Right. Wrong side. Let's do this from in here, shall we? come out here. And I was saying I wasn't going to actually mow and use this field, but as the grass has grown really long, I think we might. We might just start in here, and then we'll go and do the field over there as well. So let me just go forward a bit. We'll go over to this edge over here, and we'll do a bit in here first. So we start right here. We want to lower that one down. No, we don't. I'm going to come out of cab to see this. That one's unfolding at the moment so that it can be lowered down. There we go. That's lowered. That's the front one lowered. I'll start the front one up. And we'll just make sure, right, it's currently it's on the right setting. And if I go to the rear ones, we've got enable widespreading, turn on mower. So at the moment, that one will be just fine, just as it is. That will put everything towards the middle. It gathers it up, and basically I think what they've done is they've just included a rake into, sort of incorporated a rake mechanic into the mower to make it work. Which I don't really know how they've done it, but it does work. Let's just stay out of cab for a minute and we can see this. Because you can see the animation behind it is still sort of showing the grass dropping on the ground, but it's piling it up in the middle. Which I think is a really cool thing. It does work, so we've got a swath. We don't have to go over it with a rake or anything like that. It's absolutely brilliant. So this should cut down a whole lot of production time. Now hopefully it won't catch that gate. I think it sticks out a bit further than it actually does. I was considering doing a bit of cutting and then wrapping the bales using the baler. And then we'd have some silage bales back here that we could put in for the cows. I'm not sure about that at the moment. I don't think we will. Well, we won't today anyway. I'm going to cut all of this, and I'll cut this field right next to me, which is field 2. And I suppose after that, I don't really need to go over the road over there. We could probably just stick with what we got here. All right, that's all of that grabbed. And so now we'll start a next round. So we do two rounds like this, and then we'll start doing some land work. We might need to do three. Two should be enough. But anyway, I'm going to go on and cut this, because you've seen cutting before. And then we can come out here with our forage wagon. What we might do, actually, is hire a bigger forage wagon. That might be a more sensible option, because that forage wagon isn't the biggest one that we've ever used. Well, that's the field almost finished. I've just got one little bit down there. I can actually stop and lift the back mowers, as I've just got one little bit down there for the front mower, and then we can move into, actually, I can fold those up while this front one is going. And that's it. So if I lift that one up and stop it, we can go into the next field. I don't think we're going to need more than just these two fields for now. We will do a big grass crop at some point. I think that would be pretty cool. But we won't do that today. I just want to get a load of grass for the sheep and the cows. We might, let me just lower that one down again and start him up, and then into the back ones. I was also thinking that we need to do hay at some point so that we can start doing some mixed forage. We need to do more silage. There's quite a few things that we need to do, and it would be quite handy to have like a serious grass week, where, you know, it's basically all we do is grass crops. So we got hay to do, silage to do, and fill up troughs with grass as well. Although if we do plenty of hay, and we can do mixed rations in for the cows, we won't need to worry about giving them grass. We'll only need to worry about giving the sheep grass. Something else that I need to do is get some more cows. We've got enough money now that I could at least get 10 more cows. I can't see very well here. I'm doing this out of cab purely because it's a bit easier to see what I'm doing. I'll just come into cab for a little while, I think. So I'm going to at least finish this field. So this is what I'll do today. And then tomorrow we can pick this up. And I did say that we were going to muck out the animals up the top. So hopefully we'll have time to do both. I don't know if we will. But I might actually, I'll finish this field, I'll mow all of this field, and then I have decided I'm going to hire a bigger forage wagon. and we'll use that one just to pick up this grass and feed the animals, because I want to see what it's going to be like, and it's a good time. We got plenty of money now, so it's a good time to sort of test machinery if we're not sure about it. There is something that one rake, it's a mod from the Farming Simulator website, which I will be using when we do hay. That one does look really cool. I don't know if you remember seeing it, but you'll see it when we get on to doing the hay. That is going to be probably a few weeks' time, because I said that the next big job that we're going to do is going to be the sugar beet. So we need to do these small jobs. The animals have got nothing to eat. The cows have run out of grass. The sheep are nearly run out of grass. And I've nearly got a full pallet of wool, actually. That means I'm going to have to get that New Holland loader down from top before the next episode. I am seriously considering getting a skid steer and storing the skid steer down the bottom, and then that one can just be there for like doing the pallets, and then the New Holland loader can be driven up and down as and when we need it. Or I could keep the skid steer up at the beef and pigs so that it can deal with bales of straw up there, because that's actually the only reason that we need a loader up there, is for bales of straw. We don't need it for doing anything else, whereas down at the sheep yard we could do with the load all, because that's where we also have to load crops, and a skid steer isn't going to be able to fill the trailer properly. Now, I found it a bit tight on my last time, so I might actually do a double pass here, one extra pass on the headland. Which way? Yeah, I want to pick those up. Spin round. It doesn't like picking them up off the ground. The tractor doesn't work all that well when they're picked up for some reason. It just doesn't like the way the weight distribution works. I'm not sure why. Anyway, let's go on and do this one. I have run out of time now, so I'm going to finish. I will finish this field. I will get a hired forage wagon, and I will spend some more time thinking about a skid steer, see whether or not I'm actually going to get one. And I will see you next time. Don't forget our question for this week is, do you want me to get the auto combine mod and follow me, which we can use. I mean, obviously you can just use it for driving stuff around the map and things like that. Quite a useful little tool. But the other reason that follow me is quite handy that I've noticed is that we could leave silage on the ground like this and use a pickup reel on a forager, and the follow me mod will have the tractor following us around so that we can load it properly, which I think is actually really, really cool. That would be really really helpful and handy, which is why I'm giving the option to allow me to use it in this map. But it's your vote, it's your game. Head down below, let me know what you think. If you don't want me to, I won't be using it. It's as simple as that. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar, goodbye, and see you later.